Hello everyone, CedarNet here with another update from the Avalanche ecosystem. Today we're going to take a look at Gondola Finance. Now, Gondola Finance went live yesterday already, but farming is only live tomorrow. So I gave myself yesterday off after the banky sale, which I expected to take a lot of time. Actually didn't take much time, but didn't get very far with that one. Went for a run, caught a cold, so now I'm a bit sniffy, you may catch that. And then also it's very windy where I live right now, so if you do hear that as well, I do apologize. But let's get into it. So to explain Gondola Finance, you need to know a little bit about bridges. So as you probably know, if you supply liquidity to Pangolin or Penguin or Olive, you can often use Ethereum or another Ethereum token, like also USDT, for example. Now, these are all Ethereum-based tokens. So how did they get on the Avalanche chain? Well, these tokens have been bridged. And what bridging means is not actually literally moving one Ethereum to the Avalanche blockchain. Instead, what you actually do is you have a trusted kind of partner who operates a bridge. You give them your Ethereum, they lock it up in a smart contract, and then they issue you a token that represents that Ethereum on another blockchain. So for example, when we look at the Avalanche Ethereum bridge, I can tell them, hey, I want to send half a wrapped Ethereum to the Avalanche blockchain. Essentially, they're going to take that one and they're going to issue me on my receiving address one of their tokens, which represents a Ethereum. Now, the Avalanche Ethereum bridge is operated by trusted parties. So we kind of trust that whatever token they issue is worth one Ethereum. And in the Avalanche blockchain, we tend to call the tokens that are transferred through the Avalanche Ethereum bridge, we just call them Ethereum. But Avalanche Ethereum bridge is not the only bridge. I can also bridge my Ethereum from the Zero exchange. And it would work the exact same way, right? I can pick a wrapped Ethereum and I can say I want 0.5 wrapped Ethereum and I want it on the Avalanche chain. Now, as some of you already understand, the Ethereum token, or at least the Ethereum redeemable token that Zero exchange offers you, is not the same contract as the one that the Avalanche Ethereum bridge offers. So while they're both represent one Ethereum, from a blockchain perspective, they are not the same token. And this becomes an issue when I want to, for example, supply liquidity to Pangolin. If we look at Pangolin, the Ethereum that we're generally swapping for and adding to pools is normally the Avalanche Ethereum bridge bridged Ethereum or Ethereum redeemable token. And the same is true for PandaSwap, Penguin, Olive, you know, whichever. They all tend to use the Avalanche Ethereum bridged Ethereum. Now, with just two bridges, this is somewhat overseeable, right? There's just two kinds of Ethereum. You can figure out which one you need to add to a pool or to trade or whatever. But there are more bridges in the works. So we need some sort of solution that makes it possible to switch between these tokens or to have them, you know, seen as the same. So how does Gondola solve this problem? Well, essentially, Gondola Finance is not very dissimilar from what the faults are, the stable faults on Snowball Finance. What happens is that you add tokens to a pair that should logically be stable in value, right? So in the stable fault, there's three stable coins that should all be worth exactly $1. And that price is essentially maintained by offering incentives whenever the pool skews a little bit. So if there's too little Binance USD in there, you get a little bit more of the other tokens if you decide to do a trade. Gondola Finance works the exact same way, only instead of having different stable coins paired each other, they have differently bridged tokens paired against each other. So what I just did is I traded some of my Avalanche Ethereum bridged USDT for some Zero bridged USDT. As you can see, I get back slightly fewer as Zero USDT than I put in as Ether Ethereum bridged USDT. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add my Zero bridged USDT back into the pool so people can trade against it and I can earn some Gondola and some fees. So I'm just going to press max and you'll see I do not actually need to add some USDT to this as well. And I get a small bonus because the pool is out of balance. There is 60% AEB bridged USDT and 40% roughly Zero bridged USDT. Now all these advanced options I don't think are very relevant at this point. I'm going to confirm my deposit. And as you can see, I now have MetaMask also on screen. I figured out how to do it. And there we go. And we're updating. Good. Good. Cool. Anyway, So from tomorrow onward, I will be earning myself a little bit of Gondola. If you have some assets lying around, it may be interesting for you to add them as well, especially if you can get the bonus to bring the pool a bit more in balance. So one more time, just as a short summary, what Gondola allows you to do is switch between the differently bridged tokens for hardly any fee. Currently that's AEB and Zero, but there will be many more. Very welcome addition, and I think much needed addition to the ecosystem. If you want to give it a shot, the link will be in the description. If you have any further questions or need a deeper explanation, do not hesitate to ask in the comments. I will also link a very good explanation by the Gondola Finance team themselves. That's it for now. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope to see you in the next one. And bye bye.